Good evening, my dear friends. So welcome back to Akshi.com online education program. So today the topic we have suggested is totally new. So generally speaking, we teach synonyms and antonyms in a separate class. But in this period, we try to teach both the meanings of synonyms and antonyms in one session. So this is a new approach. New approach in the sense that when I present you an exercise, you will be puzzled by looking at there are too many words in the exercise. So why do I give two rows of words? Means first two rows of words will form synonyms, second row of words will also form synonyms. Therefore, you will learn more words with a similar meaning instantly. And equally, this exercise is also responsible to learn more words on antonyms also. For example, so look at this exercise. So this is the first two row. This is the second row. From the first row, the words are ingest, digest, imbibe, assimilate. The second row, disgorge, eject, exude, dissipate. So, this is the first row, this is the second row. First row as series of words. Second row also as series of words. In the first row, ingest, digest, imbibe, assimilate. All these words belong to first row. Disgorge, eject, exude, dissipate also belong to second row. So, ingest is the synonym of digest. Digest is the synonym of imbibe. Imbibe is the synonym of assimilate. Similarly, the words you find from the second row, disgorge is synonym of eject. Eject is the synonym of exude. Exude is the synonym of dissipate. So within a short time, you will learn many more words with synonymous meaning within a short period, within a short span of time, within a few minutes, you learn more synonyms. Synonym of exude is eject, synonym of eject is dissipate, synonym of eject is disgorge, synonym of digest is ingest, synonym of digest is assimilate. So this exercise is constructed with a great plan in order to provide an opportunity for plus 2 or plus 1 students to learn many words with the synonyms, many words with the antonyms within a short span of time. So this is my plan. So you will find some of the words from the first rows. And you also find some of the words from the second rows. As I explained earlier, disgorge is the synonym of eject, eject is the synonym of exude. So similarly, ingest is the antonym of disgorge, antonym. Digest is the antonym of eject. In such a way, you correlate the meaning of assimilate with the dissipate, antonym. Antonym. Don't say antonym. Antonym is wrong pronunciation. Antonym, synonyms. Assimilate is the word that is opposite to dissipate. Opposite to eject. Digest is the opposite to eject. Ingest is the opposite to disgorge. So side by side you learn meaning of synonyms, meaning of antonyms too. V-O-M-I-T, very ordinary word, vomit. Vomit means eject. Vomit means disgorge. Vomit means dissipate. Vomit brings something from our stomach, unwanted things, through our mouth. That is called vomit. So, vomit is the active word. Vomit is the active word and eject is the passive word. Disgorge is the passive word. Mostly synonyms and antonyms are asked in the exercises only by drawing your attention on passive words. Only passive words are tested, not active words. Only passive words are tested in the question paper. Mostly they omit active words, whereas they focus more attention on only passive words. So therefore in this exercise, since vomit is the active words, eject is passive word, exude is a passive word, dissipate is a passive word, disgorge is a passive word. Similarly, digest. Our food is digested. Fruits are easily digested. Similarly, ingested. Similarly, assimilated. Assimilate means digest. Assimilate. So, you are all teenage boys. Even if you eat stone, it will be assimilated because of your age, because of your growth, because of your energy. Even if you eat more food, more things, more snacks, it will be digested, it will be assimilated because you are in. But old people can't take anything. So those things cannot be assimilated, those things cannot be digested. So digest, opposite of vomit is digest. Opposite of vomit is assimilate. Opposite of vomit is ingest. So this is the way you can learn meaning of many more words within a short span of time. So these words are synonyms. These words are also forming a meaning of synonyms. And when you discuss by taking a word from one side and compare its meaning with the other side, it gives the meaning of antonyms. Antonyms means opposite meaning. So dissipate is the opposite to assimilate. Exude is the opposite of digest. Eject is the opposite of ingest or digest. Vomit is the opposite of assimilate. Vomit is synonym to exude. Vomit is synonym to eject. So, you must be very careful in understanding the content. Words at the first row are synonyms. Words at the second row are also synonyms. But a word from first row is the opposite to a word in the second row. A word from the second row is the opposite to a word in the first row. So you must understand this kind of correlation. Then another technique is, so before you find out antonyms or before you find out the synonym, either from the first two rows of words or second row of the words, so which one is familiar? Which word do you know from the first row or from the second row? So I am talking about the second step, or I am talking about the second method. So there are four words from the first row. From these four words, which one is familiar to you? Which one do you know? So first find it out. So similarly from the second row, which word is familiar? For example, from the first row, digest is active word. Digest everyone knows. Digest is the word that everybody knows, digest, related to eating, related to food. So digest is the known. Or assimilate, if you think assimilate is the known word, then with the help of this known word, you try to understand the meaning of ingest. You try to understand the meaning of digest with the help of the word. Suppose with the help of the word vomit, you understand the meaning of dissipate. With the help of the word vomit, you try to understand the meaning of disgorge. But eject may be an ordinary word. Maybe a known word. From the first word, digest may be the known word, or some of you assimilate may be the known word. Therefore, you try to find out the answer from the known words to new words or unknown words. So this is the methodology we follow. You find out the known word, you find out the familiar word from the first row, or find out the familiar word or known word from the second row, and then from the familiar word you try to understand unfamiliar word. Understand? If you know the meaning of the word eject, which has the meaning of vomit, you can easily find out the answer of digest. So this is the technique. So please kindly note down known to unknown. So this is the known word. Eject is the known word from the second row. Digest is the known word from the first row. From the known word from the second row, eject, we understand the meaning of dissipate. We understand the meaning of disgorge. From the word assimilate, we understand the meaning of ingest. So this is an effective methodology. I suggest you to improve your word power. Okay? So first row synonyms. Second row is also synonym. And when you compare the meaning of a word from the first row with a word from the second row, that you are talking about synonyms. Comparing of the meaning of one word from the first row with that of the meaning of a word in the second row, then you are talking about antonyms. So this is the noun. From the first row, digest is the noun. From the noun word, you try to understand the meaning of the rest of the words. So let's take second exercise. So read each word. Preposterous. This is ridiculous, not me. Ridiculous. Farcical. Logical. Sagacious. Consistent. My dear students, don't think they are new words. In fact, they are new. However, you try to understand the meaning from the known. I will write one more word. Humorous. Farcical means humorous. Jovial, humorous, farcical, comedy like type. So, preposterous means comic, ridiculous means humorous, jovial, not very much serious. The meaning of not very much serious. This is ridiculous, this is not the ridiculous. Farcical, humorous, your behavior is ridiculous. Your behavior is ridiculous. Farcical is a word that gives the meaning of humorous. So this is the word that has relevance with comic. Comic or comedy. Comic, comedy, humorous, jovial, farce, farcical, farce, farce. Farce is also a comedy that makes others laugh, but there won't be any dialogue. There won't be any dialogue by making some facial posture or twisting one's body, with which comedian makes others laugh. Comedian never uses any dialogues, but he may use his facial expression, changing his facial expression without dialogue. He may change his expression by twisting his body in an irregular way. So that's called the farce. Farce, F-A-R-C, farce. Like mock, M-O-C-K, mock. Mockery, mocking, like that. So this is the known word. So if you think farcical is the known word, with the help of the word farcical, you try to understand the meaning of ridiculous prepostures. And then sage, sagacious. It's like, you know, it gives the meaning of cleverness. Consistent, logical. Sagacious is the synonym of logical. Logical is the synonym of consistent. And my dear students, believe me, sometimes answers are very close to the correct answer. Sometimes. So you must understand the fact. When you want to find out answer for synonyms, suppose you have a question paper in your hand. You are looking at synonym exercises. So there is a question with the four options. Before you find out the answer from the four options, so you must have something in your mind how answers are printed. Sometimes answers are close to the correct answer. Sometimes answer for the synonym is close to the correct answer or nearest to the correct answer. And the third one is distant to the correct answer. So you must understand this. So out of four options, how is answer printed? Closest to answer, nearest to answer, distant answer, remote answer, like that. Because they want you cheat. They don't want to help you to find out the answer quickly, correctly. So that's why they try to confuse you by giving distant answer, by giving remote answer, by giving nearest, but not the correct answer. Exactly correct answer. So exactly correct answer, nearest answer, distant answer, And then unwanted answer. Unwanted answer means that the answer is in no way suitable to the question. So, exactly correct answer, one option, closest or nearest another option, distant or remote is another answer, and the teaser is another option. So, you must understand, before you find out the answer from synonym exercise or antonym exercise, you must have this notion in your mind. So, this is applicable even to antonyms also. This is applicable even to antonyms also. Exact answer, nearest answer, distant answer or remote answer. So, all these critical discussions, all these critical perceptions are applicable even to antonyms. So, therefore, as a grown-up student, you must understand this. Chaperone, chaperon, escort, convoy, convoy. Second one, leave, depart, misguide, misguide. Escort, escort. So this is very ordinary word. Escort, convoy. Who always follows others, like Gurkha. So, usually what will Gurkha do? So, they safeguard our homes, they safeguard our country or street or something like that. They give protection. They give protection to us. So, here, escort. Escort means someone who protects us, someone who protect us in a disturbed condition, in a disturbed condition. Escort. Okay. And similarly, chaperone means maybe a parent or teacher or relatives who takes care of. Who takes care of, especially girls, chaperone is also escort, who follows their children, especially girl children. Where do they go? Do they go to school or do they eat food? So, food nutritious or not, is the food sufficient for them? So, all things of carefulness, chaperone, teacher or parent or warden, they take care of the girls. Especially they observe or they watch adolescent girls. Those who observe adolescent girls for their health sake, for their academic sake, they are called the chaperone. Escort, convoy, one who follow others in order to give protection. This is very important. One who follow others in order to protect them. This is escort. Sometimes we may also ask our friends, so why do you escort her very often? Are you an escort to her? So why do you follow her? So we shall ask sometime. Escort. So escort is the synonym of convoy. Escort is the synonym of chaperone. Leave is the synonym of depart. Depart is the synonym of leave. Like that. So this is a distant answer. This is a distant answer. Leave it out. This is a distant answer. Escort means one who follow others for protection sake, like Gurkha. So I cited an example from Gurkha. Gurkha community is a noble community. They live for others. They live for others who have to live in a peaceful ways. They protect others. So escort convoy share program. So opposite to that, escort depart Antony. So leave them alone. Leave them independent. You need not follow, leave them. Depart. Depart them. Don't stay with them. Let them maintain. Let them take care of themselves. Why do you follow? Why do you follow? Let them take care. So this is the new word, chaperon. Chaperon is a person or a parent or a teacher who takes care of grown-up girls, especially adolescent girls. They watch girls in order to protect them from evils, in order to protect them from any disease, in order to protect them from any other social unwanted forces. Chaperon, Shah sound is important. Chaperon. Escort, a person who follows him, follows her, in order to protect him, in order to give protection to them. So, from the second row, leave is the noun. Leave is the noun. From the word leave, you understand the meaning of depart. Earlier, you may not know the meaning of depart. Depart, departure. Depart or departure. You may not know the meaning of depart. Once you look at the word leave, you may quickly understand the meaning of depart. Okay, so from the meaning of depart, you may understand the meaning of escort, or you may understand the meaning of convoy. But out of these three words, escort may be the noun or may be the active word. Active. So mostly, you know, college students or college girls may use this word. Hey, you are a big escort, you are always coming to, you are always coming with your sister. Do you think you are an escort for her? So like that. They are exchanging very harsh words. Don't behave like escort. Escort means a person who provides protection to her or protection to him like that. Protective. Person who provides protective measures to his brother or to his sister or to anybody else. So that's why I told you Gukha in the beginning. And then fourth exercise. Incriminate, indict, arraign, impeach, and the second row, exonerate, pardon. Exonerate. Look at this word, pardon. Pardon means sorry, excuse, and then sorry, pardon means. Impeach means blame. So just this is enough. You understand meaning of any other word from the first row. Anyone is enough. Understanding the meaning of anyone from the first row. Impeach. Impeach means blame. So even though impeach is not an ordinary word, this is also very difficult. Or sometimes unconsciously you can understand the meaning of the word impeach. Indict, impeach, arraign, incriminate. So the meaning of impeach is blame. Blame, accuse. Blame or accuse. So here pardon means excuse. So accuse, arraign means accuse, blame means accuse. Okay. And then pardon, then another meaning is forgive. Forgive. Another meaning is acquit. A-C-Q-U-I-T-T. Acquit. Acquit. And then another meaning, liberate. See, the meaning of pardon is excuse. Or another indirect meaning is forgive, acquit, liberate, emancipate. So all these words are opposite to impeach, arraign, incriminate, like that. So initially you learn the meaning of the word pardon. And then from the word pardon, you understand the meaning of forgive, acquit, liberate, excuse. So this is the noun word, pardon. Pardon means excuse, forgive. Impeach means accuse or blame. But this is a heavy word. You can blame ordinary person. You can blame other person. You can accuse ordinary person. But you can impeach only the President of India. You can impeach only the President, only the Prime Minister, only the Supreme Court Judge, like that. Impeach. Impeach also has the meaning of accusation, meaning of blame. But you cannot use impeach for an ordinary person. You can use this word just against the President of India or Prime Minister of India or Governor of India. Like that, you cannot use this word for ordinary person. So impeach means blame or accuse. So incriminate, indict, arraign. So it's very difficult for us to learn all the meaning of these words. So it's very difficult. I agree with you, it's very difficult. But from the known word, you can learn the meaning of unknown words. So that's why you try to understand or you try to find out the known word. Pardon is the known word. From the word, you try to understand it's an arrest. From the known word, you try to understand this impeach, blame, accuse. Appurtenance, attachment, accessory, adjunct. Appurtenance, attachment, accessory, adjunct. And second row, abstraction, deletion. So this is the known word, deletion. Deletion means removal. Remove, delete. Delete the answer, we say normally. Delete the fourth answer, that's not necessary. Delete means remove. So abstraction means deletion. Abstraction is the synonym of deletion. Abstraction is the synonym to removal. Similarly, attachment. Attachments means addition. Attachment. Addition. Another word also you can give annexer, appendix, like that. So add something to it. Appurtenance means attachment. So you write an application for the bank clerks. You write an application and then you attach your certificates, Xerox copies of all the certificates. You attach to it, you are stapling the Xerox copies of your certificates along with the application. You attach. Attach means put it together with the main application. Add to that main application. This is called attach. Attachment. Attach. Add. Addition, annexure. So accessory has the meaning of attachment, accessory has the meaning of appurtenance, accessory has the meaning of urgent. Similarly, deletion has the meaning of removal, deletion is the meaning of abstraction. Abstraction is also the word that means delete something from original. So deletion is the known word, attachment is the known word from the first word, deletion is the known word from the second row. Therefore, you have just learned the meaning of the word abstraction. You have just learned the meaning of attachment by learning the word annexer. Appurtenance, though the word appurtenance is a new word, you have just learned the meaning of appurtenance is attachment or addition or annexer or appendix. accessory, that's etc. etc. Drunkard. Drunkard, inebriate, dipsomaniac, boozer, sot. Drunkard, inebriate, dipsomaniac, boozer, sot. And then second row, teetotaler, abstainer. Teetotaler, abstainer. So look at the first two. What is the noun word? Drunkard is the noun. Rest of the words are unknown words. From the known word, you must understand the meaning of the rest of the words. Meaning of these words are close or near or distant or remote. Don't worry about that. Initially, you try to learn the meaning of these words at the surface level, only at the surface level. That's enough. Learn the meaning only at the surface level. Then after that, when we apply understanding of all these words in different exercises, we try to analyze it separately. But as a first attempt, you try to understand the similar meaning, meaning of synonyms. So drunkard, a person who drinks alcohol, fermented liquid, a person who drinks alcohol too much, regularly, every day, sometimes he goes unconscious, by means of consuming more, heavier liquid. So dipsomaniac, boozer, drunk is also possible, drunkard is very old word, drunk, which means drunkard. Person who consumed more alcohol, more quantity of alcohol. Inebriate means drunkard, dipsomaniac drunkard, sot means drunkard, boozer means drunkard. See, how many new words you are learning? So sometimes you have to by heart the meaning of these words. So there is no other way. There is not a shortcut method to remember the meaning of all these words. I told you only one shortcut method. You try to understand the meaning of the rest of the words by understanding the noun word. Drunk is the noun word. Similarly, teetotaler. Similarly, abstainer. Abstainer means to keep away from liquid. One who keeps away from alcohol. Who is a teetotaler? One who keeps away from drinking alcohol. Drinking beer, drinking alcohol, drinking brandy, wine, etc. They are called a teetotaler. So, some of the car owners will write teetotaler on the mirror, on the glass panel of the car. Teetotaler. Teetotaler means a person who never drinks alcohol. Teetotaler. So the opposite. Drunkard. Teetotaler is an antonym to the word of drunkard. Abstainer. Abstain from alcohol. Abstain from Tasmak shop. Abstain from Pondicherry shops. Understand? Abstainer means say no to alcohol. Like say no to drugs. Similarly, say no to alcohol. Abstainer. Teetotaler. A kind of disciplinarian. Teetotaler is a kind of disciplinarian who never touches alcohol. So, how many words you have learned? Sot, boozer, dipsomaniac, inebriate. All these words refer to the meaning of drunkard. Opposite drunkard is abstainer, opposite drunkard is teetotaler. Don't forget this word, teetotaler. So, kindly read out all the words. Allegiance, fealty, fidelity, loyalty, treachery, rebellion, treason, disloyalty. So now, may I ask you the viewers, to encircle the known word from the first row quickly. May I ask you the viewers, or may I ask you the online learners to encircle the known word from the first row and encircle the known word from the second row quickly. Use your emails. Are there any students who are quick at giving your answer? Allegiance, fealty, fidelity, loyalty. Loyalty. Treachery, rebellion, treason, disloyalty. No answer from you. Loyalty. Loyalty. Being faithful. Faithful, trustful, reliance. Allegiance. So this is the keyword, loyalty. This is the known word, loyalty. You must be loyal to your parents. You must be faithful to your parents because they educate you. Because they spend every penny for your education, then you must be loyal. So loyal, loyalty, fidelity, fealty, allegiance, seriousness, commitment, reliance, faithfulness. Sincerity. So opposite to these words is disloyalty, treason. There is another word also, infidelity. Fidelity, infidelity. Being faithful to husband, being faithful to one's wife, like that. Treason. Rebel, so this is another word, rebel, rebellion. Fight against one system. Treachery means treason. Losing one's faith against the country. Treason, treachery. He was punished for his treason. So because he sold his country's secret to his neighboring country for money. Treason. Great mistakes. It's a kind of betrayal. Selling one's own country to others for money's sake, for gold's sake, for some other facility's sake. Rebel, treason, treachery, disloyalty. So, allegiance opposite to treachery, fealty opposite to treason, fidelity is opposite to treason, fidelity is opposite to infidelity, loyalty is opposite to disloyalty. So within 1 or 2 minutes, you learn lot of synonyms, you learn lot of antonyms. You must be punished for your disloyalty. You must be punished for your treason. You always rebel against the government. Rebel. So why do you rebel? Why do you rebel against your government? You seem to be a rebellion. Don't behave like that. You will be punished seriously. Once you become a rebellion, then you seem to be disloyal to your country. So these words are really high-sounding words. If you want to be a patriotic citizen, you must be loyal. You must be allegiance to your government. You must be allegiance to your system. You must not be disloyal. Disloyal means faithless. You can do any crime for money's sake. Treason. Treachery. Treachery cannot be excusable. Treachery. Crime against the government. Secret activities. Treachery. By selling one's secrecy. by selling country's secrecies to other government. That is treachery. It's a kind of sin. Sin or crime. So cannot be excused. So the next one. Amateur dabbler dilettante. Amateur dabbler dilettante. Dilettante. Then expert professional connoisseur. Connoisseur. Look at the word again. Amateur dabbler dilettante. Then expert professional connoisseur. Amateur. Add one more word, immature. Immature. Amateur means immature. So what's the meaning of the rest of the words? Dabbler is amateur. Who is dilettante? He is also amateur. So who is an amateur? Amateur is a person who has not learned all types of arts. So he is just learning, amateur. So he is a beginner. He is a beginner of learning arts. He is a beginner to learn any kind of skill. Amateur means a beginner. Immature, I told you, immature. Amateur artist. We may say amateur artist. Amateur artist means he is beginning to learn arts. He is beginning to learn dramatic skills. He is not a veteran. He is not a veteran actor. Veteran actor. He is not veteran actor like Shivaji Ganesan. Veteran actor. He is an amateur. He has just entered to the field. Beginning to learn skills. Beginning to learn arts. Beginning to learn dramatic skills. Amateur. So look at the meaning of the rest of the words. Expert. Opposite to amateur is expert. Expert, and add another word, I wrote that, veteran. Veteran artist. Veteran doctor. Veteran. Veteran means highly experienced. Highly experienced. One cannot compare with the skills he possessed. Veteran. Expert is the synonym of professional is the name of connoisseur. Connoisseur also has the meaning of expert. Meaning of expert only in the field of art. Only in the field of art, painting, food, preparation of food and sculpture. Connoisseur means a person who is an expert in art, painting, sculpture design and preparation of hygienic food, etc. Connoisseur. So, expert is a known word. Is a known word. From the known word, you understand the meaning of connoisseur. So some people know the meaning of the word expert, some people know the meaning of expert, some people know the meaning of veteran. But probably connoisseur is the new word. Connoisseur is the new word. Which means expert. Expert in which field? Art field, painting field, sculpture field, that is fine arts field. Fine arts. Fine arts means paintings, design, sculpture, etc. So here you must remember the meaning of the word dabbler, dilettante, which means mature person, which means beginner to learn a trade, like apprentice, dilettante, immature, dabbler. Opposite to veteran, opposite to experienced, professional, expert. You can also take down the meaning of experienced. Experienced, highly experienced, professional, comely, gorgeous, charming, and uncomely, ugly, Gorgon. So probably these words are totally new to you, except the last one, charming is the one. From the word charming, understand the meaning of gorgeous, comely means extremely attractive, extremely attractive, comely girl, extremely attractive. So gorgeous means attractive personality. So charming is attractive. Gorgeous also has the meaning of attraction. Comely has also meaning of attraction with the extreme attraction. You cannot compare the beauty of that girl, because she is extremely beautiful, she is extremely attractive. No one can compare. None can be compared with the beauty. None can be compared with the structure of that girl, or structure of the woman, or structure of the man like that. Comely means highly attractive, extremely attractive. No one can be compared. Gorgeous also, attractive personality. So surface level meaning is beautiful. Surface level meaning. So what's the opposite of all these words? Ugly. This is ugly words. Everybody knows. Then Gorgon. Gorgon means ugly. Awkward or clumsy. Clumsy, awkward. Opposite to charming. Dirty also you can add. Dirty, clumsy, ugly. So all these words are active words, but gorgon, uncomely, comely, uncomely, antony. So kindly remember the meaning of the word comely, gorgeous. So once you understand the meaning of the word comely, automatically you will understand the meaning of the word uncomely and gorgon. What's gorgon? Gorgon means ugly. Gorgon means ugly. Gorgon means clumsy. Gorgons means shabby. Gorgons means shabby. So this is the way you can improve your word power. This is the way you can understand the meaning of the unknown words with the help of the known words. Charming is the known word. From the word charming, you understand the meaning of the word gorgeous, comely. So ugly is the known word. From the known word ugly, you understand the meaning of God. So, 10th one. Apprentice, neophyte, novice, tyro. Veteran, virtuoso, expert, connoisseur. We have just seen some of the words from the previous exercise. So first of all, tell me which word is known to you from the first one. Neophyte, or novice, or tyro. So this is the one. Apprentice. Apprentice, noun form. Apprentice, verb form. Apprentice means a person who learns part in the beginning. Or a person who is beginning to learn a work. A person who is beginning to learn a work, or who is beginning to learn your art. Learn an art. Apprentice. A person is appointed who has no skills. He is learning skills. He is yet to learn skills. So he is a man with plain hands. His hands are not skilled. yet to learn. So that type of personality is called operantis or operantis. Or beginner of the trail. Beginner of the trail. So he is learning the trail. He is learning the skills gradually. So what is the opposite? Highly experienced. Opposite to apprentice is veteran, experienced, expert, connoisseur. Apprentice means amateur. Apprentice means a man beginning to learn an art, beginning to learn a skill, beginning to learn a trade, apprentice or apprentice. So synonym to neophyte, synonym to novice. Novice means inexperienced person, novice. Connoisseur is an expert in arts, expert in painting, expert in designing, expert in food, etc. etc. Virtuoso is also highly experienced. So from the known world, you try to understand the meaning of the unknown. So far we have seen only 10 exercises. If you learnt meaning of 8 to 10 words from each exercise, by this time you must have learnt the meaning of more than 100 words. More than 100 words, I think. Or by this time you must have learnt the meaning of 70 to 80 words for 1 hour duration. For 1 hour duration, you have just to learn the meaning of synonyms, the meaning of antonyms from the range of 80 to 90 words. I'm sure. So only a few words are known to you. Only with the help of a few words, you understood the meaning of many more words there. So by picking out only one known word, you try to understand the meaning of the unknown words. So keep this technique with you. Have a nice day. We shall recall from the next class. Thank you very much.